this shit right here. Okay, I guess I gotta give context. So this guy's cousin used to be a former Ronald McDonald, like one of the Ronald McDonalds, or the clowns. Because there was like a, like Freemasonry type thing, community with the Ronald McDonalds apparently, which he further explains. But Sal's mind blown by it because this guy's podcast is Sal from Impractical Jokers and this other guy named Joe. This other comedian named Joe. And this fucking... This... And the Joe, he's like a huge McDonald's fan. He like loves fucking McDonald's. So the fact that he's gone and then he's finding out this information that this dude's cousin used to be a Ronald McDonald, and then they get him on the phone because Sal's like so fascinated by it. So yeah,
Ronald McDonald on it.
Okay. If he doesn't get back to us now,
yeah,
let's still have him get Ooh. Back to us.
He is. He called.
This like is fucking great to me. I don't know why.
It's destiny.
Yeah.
I mean, Ian popped up on the ad.
Yeah, it is. All right. Cousin, we will not use a last name.
He said he'll talk about it in a third party.
Professional clown.
Okay. Yeah, but you know what? I'm going to end up having an hour's worth of questions for him. So why don't we
get it up?
What? He's
you
calling right now?
Yeah.
You got it. All right, let's put this on pause.
Okay.
This is great.
Hey.
Yo.
What's up?
What's up, man? How are you doing?
That does not sound like the voice of Ronald. First question, did he have to change his voice or did he use that voice?
Can I put you on the phone with my friend Sal?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Hey.
Hey, Sal. How you doing?
Good, buddy. So Ian's here. We're doing a podcast. And Ronald McDonald came up and he said that at one point you worked as a Ronald McDonald.
Yes, that is true.
Okay. Do you have... A free hour. We're gonna change your voice.
Right.
What year were you a Ronald?
Oh man, it was like 1994 to about 2001, so it was kind
of prime years of the Ronald McDonald. He probably says this right after I just fucking pause it. Prime years of the Ronald.
You were a Ronald for seven. Ronald. Years?
He was a Ronald during 9/11.
You were a Ronald during 9/11?
Yeah, it was actually.
Was it your full-time job?
It was my full-time job.
Holy
He was the guy! That's the finance! That's the finance! Just don't fuck around! We ain't just a piddly, we full-time McDonald's!
Wow! Alright, I'm blown away.
He's a full-time Ronald!
I'm blown away that this topic came up and Ian... has a cousin that we got on the phone that was a full-time Ronald for seven years.
Does he have the costume?
Yeah, man. There's guys that do it for like 20 years.
You're shitting me. Okay, so I have so many questions. I don't know if we're going to get these battles. Okay, Brian, here we go. Okay? What made you initially go? We might not do the rest of the battles. We might have to continue this or I might go late.
Whatever you need.
What made you seek employment? As a Ronald, were you dabbling with clowns?
Why the fuck are we all fascinated by... Why did McDonald's do this? I just think about this more and more. Every time I watch this video, I have the same thought. Why did we allow a fucking clown to be involved with kids at a fast food joint? Riddle me that. Tell me. Makes no fucking sense. It's creepy as shit.
Shit already? Or was this just right place, right time? Was it something you always thought about? Was it romantic for you? Was this something that fell in your lap and you were like, I can't believe I'm going to do this. I never thought I'd be a Ronald. We'll start there.
Yeah, I lost a bet.
No way. No way.
I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Oh, okay. He's kidding. He's kidding. That's amazing.
I've seen this so many times,
like,
I believe it.
So I was doing clown stuff, like, from the age of 12. It was like a classic runaway and join the circus type of story, right, for me?
You were?
Yeah, yeah. So, and
you ran away and joined the circus to be a clown?
Not far. But, you know, I was doing like, I was juggling and doing magic when I was like 12 years old and was doing some like kids theater. And then I started doing birthday parties and, you know, kind of started kind of performing at bigger venues, yada, yada, yada. Go to college. And then like every weekend I'm doing like festivals and I auditioned for Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Clown College.
No way. You have to.
That's pretty tight. This is an this is a fascinating fucking story, actually.
Audition for the college. You can't just cut a check and they have faith in you.
No, it's it's not like the Vry. Okay.
That's what I'm saying.
Wait, okay.
So, there are worse jobs.
Felicity Huffman. Like, I'll give you money. Get my kid in.
So you must have clown friends then.
Yeah, yeah.
You're running clown circles.
We drive in a very small car together. Yeah.
So is there like when you want to be in this world and you have people, like-minded people that want to be in this world, like comedians, let's say, like me and Ian, like you must be talking about the nature of this world and its goings on all the time, right? Like, I made it onto Ringling Brothers. I didn't. I booked this big gig. I learned this new trick, yada, 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 as you said, right?
Exactly.
Is Ronald McDonald like
the SNL?
Is it the pinnacle? Like, are you gonna be like, dude, you know what I'm shooting for? I want to be a Ronald one day. Or is Ronald looked at, because tell me if I'm wrong.
Hang on.
I was like, I feel like Ronald is kind of.
This is such a fascinating question. This is such a great question for former Ronald McDonald. This man is fascinating shit. Is fascinated as shit. Love this dude. Love Sal. He's a great dude.
An imposter syndrome type clown because he doesn't focus on all the things that make a clown what a clown is. He just comes in the outfit and then he's, you know, just talking with children. And
he almost like clown stolen valor.
It's stolen valor. It really is.
No. So the backup to your first question, right, is like, do we all talk like what clown gigs are there out there for clowns to go get? And yeah, like everybody that's in Ringling knew the boss clown of Ronald McDonald. This guy's
AJ.
AJ.
Yeah! We just read about AJ. You know AJ?
Yeah, he just passed away like a week or so ago.
AJ just died! AJ passed away a week ago!
We could have
him! I gotta give context to this. They were just talking about Joe and the way I paused his face. They were just talking about the like VP of or the president of the Ronald McDonald Club. I think he was like the main Ronald McDonald. And Joe was like saying that he wanted to meet this guy so bad or something like that. Or he like wanted to know about his life so bad or something like that. Basically, he was like fascinated by him. That was the whole conversation before this podcast. And now it's just full circle to Sal. It like happened within like weeks, that conversation, and then this one. So he's fucking mind blown. As you can tell, he's fucking mind blown.
AJ just.
Yeah, he just passed away like a week or so ago.
AJ just died.
AJ passed away a week ago.
We could have had him on the pod.
Play the lotto.
We have to dedicate this episode.
We have to. What are the odds? What are the odds? Something's weird today. Something's weird today. We're having way too many coincidences happen. How do you know that AJ died a week ago? Did you keep in touch? Is there a newsletter? Yes. Is there an alumni letter?
Yeah, there's an alumni face group of all the former Ronalds.
And, my
we need that.
God.
We need that.
This is as good as I had hoped.
Holy shit.
So wait, so then did you have other clown friends that weren't Ronalds that became Ronalds with you, and then you had Ronald friends?
Yes, so like all walks of life became Ronalds.
What's
so
that?
Like magicians, all different walks of life could become a Ronald. So there's guys that were magicians that became Ronald. There are guys like me that were like clowns that became Ronald.
Was there like Ronald resentment?
Even actors. We even had a couple comedians.
Was there Ronald resentment?
Became Ronald. So if you're a performer.
Who?
Comedians?
Yeah.
There's a guy by his stage name is Nick Beef. He was actually in New York City for a while.
Nick Beef?
Beef, yeah.
Well, that is his stage Nick name. Beef? That wasn't his real name.
Nick Beef!
It was not.
Nick Beef! Wait, guys,
Nick Beef became Ronald McDonald. That's hysterical. He ended up pushing beef.
Oh my God.
That seemed like a natural fit.
Oh my, dude, you're blowing up. Who is Nick Beef?
Well, I'll tell you what, if you Google him, he actually owns the gravestone next to Lee Harvey Oswald, if you want to check that out.
Dude, this goes so deep!
We're down a wormhole right now!
Dude, when he said that, when I first watched this, I genuinely thought the same fucking thing. Oh my God.
Cover something here.
Nick Beef! The Ronald McDonald owns a grave next to Lee Harvey Oswald!
You're gonna find out some shit right now.
Nick Beef is Oswald! Oswald is Nick Beef!
It is.
Yeah, if you pull on this conspiracy string long enough, you're gonna find out that Grimace killed JFK.
That's where we're headed. So wow. Nick Beef, but what is Nick Beef, like, why is he in the, why is there an article on The Atlantic written about him?
About Nick Beef? Did you just look it up? I think it probably tells a little bit of story, right? That, you know, he had the Stoke gravestone.
A JFK mystery. The name of the article is A JFK Mystery. Who is Nick Beef? Yeah. Oh my God.
Well, I know Nick Beef too.
Nick Beef. What was his? Who's his real name?
Nick Beef kind of sounds like a McBeef, which is kind of a McDonald's sandwich.
On your podcast.
So
I'm not sure what he's doing today.
Was there Fat Ronald who got cut?
Yeah.
That question. Listen to it.
Was there
Sandwich
on your podcast?
So okay. So
I'm not sure what he's doing today.
Was there Fat Ronald who got cut?
Yeah. So.